Hey guys, and welcome to the Trial of the Spheres. We're finally gonna finish up Celestia and finish this place completely.
Ancient puzzles to be solved. What happens when the stars are aligned?
So the first part, there's three treasures, or there's three parts. You have to align all the stars.
Find more light on the problem.
You have to align all the stars here. You have to align all these together. And I think there's a certain way to do it. I can't fully remember it.
Is it wisdom?
And then on this one, you just have to turn all the heads so they point inward. Out of all of them, I think this is the hardest one. I can heal. Need it. Okay, and oh, okay, I guess he knows how to do this one.
It's
been such a long time since I've done this. I've only done this area about two times before. Once it was to help one of my friends. But yeah, basically you just have to keep clicking through them until they're all lit up. That's about it. And I think you have to go for the one that's not lit. Possibly. Oh man, this is a bit frustrating, seeing as how I don't remember how to do this. Oh, there we go. We got all of them. So yeah, you have to go until each one of them is lit. So you go through the non-lit ones. And then I think there's one more puzzle, which is the heads. So this one, you just line up all the stars together, and that's how you pass that one really easy. Like I said, the hardest one out of all of these puzzles is that one over there. Other than that, all these are really easy. There you go, and there you go. That's this puzzle solved too. All three puzzles are solved. Now we can continue on. What deck do I have? All right, I have my good deck, and I'm gonna put more Sayers in. Drop more Sayers. I'm gonna get rid of you. All right, there we go. Let's continue on. So yeah, guys, I'm so excited to be doing this. Finally gonna finish this up. It's gonna be so easy. Well, I say so easy, but it's going to be fun and all to finish cheats. So his cheat is, I don't remember his cheat. Do you remember this cheats? Just do that, because it's been such a long time, so I'm pretty much like, I know the bosses and stuff, but I'm pretty much going in blank right now because I don't know like what I'm supposed to do. I can't remember. When we have to kill the minions first, so don't hit this turn. So yeah, I think that's the cheat, if I'm not mistaken. Oh man, this is gonna be hectic. That's an interesting spell. It's a sun spell. Okay. So, Trevor here, he's level 110, and as again, thank you all of you guys for your help. Especially thank you for Trevor, who is the highest level out of all of us, and he can pretty much just... I think he could just level this entire area by himself. Without a problem. Maybe. Well, maybe. I mean, maybe once we hit 110 or max level, whatever it will be by the time we hit it, we will try to do this place again and see if we can solo it, because I think it'd be fun. I know definitely we could solo Malastare at that point. Like, once we hit level 70, we'll be able to solo Malastare already, because he's just that easy. This place is still a bit hard to do. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the new start of Diablo Season 7. I'm enjoying that a lot. Yeah, I can't wait to max level a wizard with you guys. It's gonna be loads of fun. No problem. Dang it. Mist. What? I don't know what that guy's talking about. Power crow up. I can crow. And that will kill the minions. Alright, let's do this. Let's crow. Should do a fair amount of damage. So we have Michael here. He's death like me. We have Adam here, which is Storm. And then we have, of course, Trevor, who is Myth. And he is gonna be the one to carry us pretty much through this dungeon. And again, thank you so much, Trevor, for your help. If you do see this video, Trevor, leave a comment down below for me, and say hi or something, so I know that you I knew that I was talking to you or something. I don't know. Well, this sucks. What was it? Need more pierce. Yeah. I don't think I have any pierce. Oh, by the way, I have a new wand, which is something. Let's split up while we can. I will be able to split up an overtime on him, though. And that will actually be pretty strong, I think, because it will pop his shield. I don't know if it'll work. Will an overtime spell work? So overtime doesn't work either. I guess I don't know if he used one of these, but I'll just give it to him. No, don't use skeleton. Okay, well, Michael's gonna screw us over here. But we might kill. I hope we kill. Because Trevor is using the Mantis dude. The one that you see is like huge leg for something. Oh, he crit. It won't now attack Trevor. Okay, well, let's see if it won't come back. And it's not back yet. All right, that works. Okay, it's nice. It's a good spell. I don't know if he already had these blades or not, but if he didn't, there you go, Trevor. Damn, you see the leg. I think from now on we should call it the leg, because it's a giant leg. Please tell me this is gonna be GG. Yeah, this is definitely gonna be GG, and he did not have a spirit blade, sweet. And that's GG. Right? No, by far, 51,000. Oh, jeez. Just think about it. That spell does damage to everything. What did we get?
The teleporter opens. Now you can face the trial of the moon.
We got a life amulet.
Who can match the phases of the moon?
New wands. This is our new ones. 32% critical rate. 22% resist. Yeah, I'll go over it at the end of it. I don't want to really waste too much time. So here we have to fight each one of these guys. You have to align. Which one is it? Yeah, so it's that one. You have to align it so it's pointing at you, I think. Yeah. Alright, so I need a... I think I should change decks. Yeah, let's go in. I think I can take these guys on by myself. I mean, it shouldn't be too hard. We fought these guys before. They don't have too much health. Got this one, I said, oh my god, dude, why would you come in? You should have gone to the other ones. Oh well. Can't be helped now. Well, we should take him out. So, the way you do it is you have to align the right moon so it's pointing towards this. And then, after you defeat him, you get a chest. I think either with a sword or a scimitar, which is a curved sword, or a shield, I think, or it's all shields or all scimitars. And then you have to go place him on the statues, and then after you have all four, you can open the gate. This one's pretty easy. There is a way you can do it to bypass all of this, and it's a bit of a pain to do. What you do is... When you're standing at the gate, you have to have a friend stand and look at the gate directly, and then you'll go around, and then while you're going around, you're teleported while you're still walking, and then you can glitch through it. I don't know if they fixed that glitch or not, but if they didn't, that's how a lot of people back in the day used to get through this place. You would just pretty much just hack through the wall. Yeah, I want the card so bad. Cannot find it. Lore Master drops it. Okay, so I should have used my new wand and show you guys. I haven't even seen it myself. I think it'll be cool since it's life now. It's gonna be a bit better. And I mean, yes, I got rid of 10 damage, but that's all right. I got some more crit, and I got some more resist to crit, which is pretty nice right now. I mean. Yeah, they crit and all. Or you can get it in the night. Night lore pack. That's how I got it. You guys remember back in the day we got it. You didn't really have to come and help me forever. Or you didn't really have to come and help us here. But, or not Trevor, Adam. But, alright, that's fine, thank you. Oh. Ow. I told them, fight the Lore Master. Lore Master in ES drops it. Yeah, a Lore Master drops some new some of the cards, usually. Any of the ones that have, like, Lore Pack, that's where you can drop. They drop them and you can get them. Or you can also craft it in Avalon. You gotta show me a little meantime. Sure, I'll show him later. I don't really want to fight the lore master because it's just a pain to do. It's really not hard. I did it by myself. I'll swear. Dear knight. Dear knight. There we go. Spin your blade, dear knight, and take these guys out. They did do a fair bit of damage to me, which I'm kind of worried about because I don't have bottles again. Yeah, it's a good five drop spell. You healed yourself, nice. Oh, you healed me. Oh, nice. Thank you very much. All right, let's grab this.
You have a moon shield. It is far too heavy to use. Perhaps it was made for someone bigger than you.
So it is the shield that you get, not the scimitar. Let's do this. There you go. Where's Trevor at? Looks like... I'll go do the last one then. Okay, let's go do the last one and then we can get through this gate and be done with it. Okay, pop this thing open. Just spin it around, as you guys can see. You have to align the moon with the right one to open up the gate. And then we can go in and take it out. Take these guys out. They're not too hard. But again, about two deer knights just does it. I think one deer knight would be enough if you use it with a, what's it called? A blade, maybe? I think it would be enough to take them out with the blade. Ah, stupid shields. I hate that shield. Alright, let's see. Okay, I think I will blade up first. And then I will hit the upcoming turn to maybe. Everyone's here as a full group. I love the snake that Adam has. It's a great snake. Take a look at it, Adam. There you are. What does it actually drop? It'll give healing current, storm spear. That's pretty good. This guy's crit every one of those now. What's his crit rate? Crit. Well, that explains it. Really? You had to put that on me? Alright. Swing your blade, dear knight, and take these guys out already. I think Trevor will take them out. If all of us hit, they're definitely dead. But I'm pretty sure I'm gonna fizzle this. No, we passed. Wow, we actually powered through that. I'm so surprised right now. I may not sound it, but I actually am. Hey. And that's gonna be GG right there because I crit. Easy money right there. Okay, I remember where the scimitars are. The scimitars are after this one. So it goes stars, which was the first room with the puzzles and the first boss, moon with this, and then sun, which was the last one. Then you have to fight a boss after each room. After each puzzle, there's a boss. That's just how it goes in this place.
You have a moon
shield. Yes, I know we have a moon shield.
Perhaps it was made for someone bigger than you.
You are not as charming as you.
And there's the last Zodiac.
Consider that.
Alright. I might have to heal someone here. What's his cheat? Okay, so we have Rage. I'm just gonna pass. You know, I might look it up on my phone, because I actually don't remember. Celestia Boss's cheat. Just blades. Alright. So it looks like we can use only blades. That's fine. And shields. Don't need that. Yeah, why not? Let's hit with Deer Knight. Because it will probably be enough to take the minions out over time, I hope. And that's his cheap. Okay, what is this guy? I think he's gonna hit me with Leviathan now. I really, really hope he does. If anyone, it should be me that he hits. I barely did any damage to him, but he looks pretty cool. I guess he's one of the last survivors of the Moon Kingdom. I wish that crit, because I would have killed. Or would have come really close to killing. Alright, so let's see. Sorry that I'm not as talkative right now, but because I'm trying to focus on this too. It's a bit harder to do. What else can I say? Yeah, so tomorrow, this week, there is a blue collection. Pokemon Red and Blue collection, the Blastoise EX one coming out. On my channel, which look forward to that. That was a pretty fun one to open up also. Yeah, got some other cool cards in it. Sure, no problem. Okay, I don't know. So you can use blades. Doesn't look like you can use traps. You have charmed your way into my heart. That's kind of you to say, but I'm kind of good without you having said that to me. You kind of a creepy bastard. I'm guessing he was the one left to guard this place for the moon, maybe, since he is actually alive still. He's not a ghost, which you guys can tell because he's not ethereal and you can't see through him. But we're making record time. This is all gonna go up at once. I'm not gonna cut it into pieces or anything like that. This is gonna go as one episode to take them out of the Celestia Dungeon. And next time around, we're gonna be doing the, what's it called? The Zafaria. We're gonna start off with Zafaria next time around. And we'll, I think I might just put in the, what are they called? I keep spacing out. Well, not spacing out, forgetting what I'm trying to say. The Lounging Lizards. It'll be a separate video. I thought I might put it at the end of this one, but it's gonna be a separate video. Oh, that deer, sorry, I was finishing up my tea. You guys know me and my tea, I love it. Stun immune, this was when they introduced bosses as being stun immune, which sucked back in the day. It was the worst thing ever. You've charmed your way into my heart. Barely did any damage again. Oh well. That's not good. Don't need this. Don't need this. I only need one of these, and then I can set up a secondary blade. So that's a pain. He's almost dead though, which is pretty nice. Pretty easy to do. Now they have, you guys see that popped up, Touch of Fire Flower is offline. Or they actually have a pop-up when it says who's online and who's offline, which is pretty cool that they added that. There we go. So he does take off any traps you put on him. And any shields by the looks of it. Cool. That works. Tower shield. No, not tower shield. Please don't. That. Oh, okay, it's frostbite. We'll be fine. Okay. So, let's see. I'm gonna dragon, I think. Yeah, let's dragon, and then I can worry about healing these guys after this. I use this spell. Oh, actually, never mind. I'll just do this now. Let's see. Yeah, I'll just heal Trevor for now, because without him, this dungeon will be extremely hard to do. It'll be easier because we have Adam, who's a storm that does insane damage, and but it'll be a bit harder without Trevor still. Because of Trevor's such a high level. There we go, we're gonna heal him up. I don't think this will. Well, he's almost back to full health. And there's the leg again. It really is such a dramatic view on the leg. And there's the crit, and that's GG. There we go. Easy money, 19,000 damage. Not as much as the last one, but still, insane damage.
The teleporter opens. Now you can face the trial of the sun.
That's actually pretty good right there. Oh, we got the boost that you used to have to get in back in the day.
The warden is.
We're gonna skip that and we'll move this.
Reflection. Does the matter become crystal clear?
So here you have to get the blades. Alright, you have to do this. I'll show you guys, hopefully with at least one of these. What you do is you have to angle this down until it's shining on the crystal. And then a chest spawns down there. And then you have to come back down without being pulled into a fight. Grab the chest. This time it's a golden one.
Sword. It is far too heavy to use. Perhaps it was made for someone bigger than you.
So sun sword, there we go. The moon shield and the sun sword. And the stars were basically, the stars let you in, the moon is the shield, and the sun is the blade. That's basically how it works. It's pretty cool. I mean, it's pretty easy puzzle also. They're all not, like I said, the hardest one was the moon one. And we need to grab this chest here.
You have a sun sword. It is far.
Yeah, we know.
Perhaps it was made for someone bigger than you.
We have to help this guy out now. Alright, well, we got it open so we can go into the Sanctum of the Star, I think. That's what it's called. Yeah, Sanctum of the Star. And let's see how much experience we actually get for this quest. Okay, easy. They're easy to take out. Let's see, who should I heal? Adam. And I think I need the heal right now. Yeah, I'll heal Adam instead of myself. I would heal myself, but I can take some damage. Adam has less health than any of us right now because, as always, Storm is not health-wise the strongest. I think, Ice is the strongest by health, with health by far. I think at 110, they can have like 10, almost 10,000 health. It's ridiculous. It's a ridiculous amount of health that they can have. Like, blown away at that amount of health that they actually give them. Alright, well. Yeah, that's why death was really cool. You can heal yourself as death, and almost all your spells, about half the spells that you use, heal you. The next spell that we get is at level 78, I think. No, 68, which is Frankenstein, I want to say. I think it is Frankenstein. There it is. Tempest and all this glory. Love Tempest. Use it so much. Alright, let's go in.
Someone has disturbed my sanctum. Enter and welcome your fiery doom.
So this is the last dungeon of Celestia, guys. You're basically on the sun. How are we not burned to death? No clue. And we all just got pulled. So her name is Mithraea, something like that. What's her cheat? As I don't remember her cheat either. Mantle stuff. Someone blade, oh. Okay, I blade it. I can blade. Thanks so much for the help, guys. You guys can see this video later today on my YouTube channel. Yeah, this will be up today. I can't wait for you guys to see this because we're finally gonna finish up this place and I'm hyped. It's gonna be awesome. So yeah, I'm like so hyped. I can't wait to start Zafaria, guys. Oh, I might actually record an episode today because I'm so hyped about it. Won't mantle us anymore. Oh, cool. So I'm gonna have to pass on the rage right now. Let's do this. Storm. Stormzilla. Well, I kind of forgot that she can use that spell. Yeah, I think she drops a pet. Let's check online. What was her name? I can't see her name anymore. Alright, there's the fizzle. There we go. I knew that would happen. That was actually a pretty cool sound. I've never heard that spell fizzled. Really nice sound. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, he bladed. Cool. The cards align. Now's your chance. Mithraea. Wizard 101 Wiki. Let's see. Dear Knight. Mithraea. Let's see. Use smokescreen on all. Guiding Light, Regeneration, Rebirth, Dryad, Solar Blades. Which is an interesting one. I don't think they have that for other people right now. It's 35% to the next Life Storm and Fire spell, so that's the spells that she can use. Clearance Ward, remove one negative, basically remove one trap of her. Dark Winds, which is the Storm Bubble. Wild Bolt, Kraken, Stormzilla, Trident, and Tempest. Now for her drops, does she drop any cool pets? She drops the crown pet, Sea Dragon. She drops Crocotopia Master Duel, Rattlebones Exalted Duel, Zeus Exalted Duel, which is pretty cool. She drops a on holidays, she drops the Storm Rider Hair Mount, which is, what is this? What does it look like? Oh, it's the like Colorful Bunny. GG. Come on, let's get the pet. I want the pet. She drops a baby bird wand on holidays only. But she has some holiday stuffs. Stuff. That's pretty cool. And GG. We finished Celestia, guys. Again, thank you so much for all the help. There we go, Celestia, guys, has been finished. We got amulet from her, which I'm gonna sell. We got, that's okay. Boots, don't really care for it. We got a gargantuan. Not as good as the thing we have right now. We didn't really get anything good. Later. I'm sorry for the gaps. Alright, let's get out of here and turn this quest in, guys. Boom, bada bang, bada boom. That's how we do it. We leveled also, guys. We hit level 63. Awesome. Turn this quest in.
You made it out alive. I had lost hope. You should go back to Wizard City and tell Halston Baelstrom what you've discovered about Celestia.
So now we have to talk to Baelstorm. Let's go home. Home sweet home. We have finished this place. Alright, let's see. Let's see this. Talk to Baelstorm. Come on, move faster. I'll finish up completely with Celestia, even though I love Celestia so much. That was so long to finish, guys. That took forever. The longer the harder the words, the longer it takes, though, to be fair.
Simply astonishing! Your adventures in Celestia are right out of legend! Thank you ever so much again for your assistance to the Spiral Geographic Society and to my friend Thurston. Still though, I must confess that the reappearance of Queen Morgant has me in a bit of a fright. It's certain that she plans no good thing for the Spiral. We must always be on our guard against her.
There we go. One sec, let me finish up. Alright, so what's this?
Young wizard, I need a favor. Please come to my office in the commons as soon as you can.
Alright, let's go talk to Ambrose really quickly now because he wants something from us. See what that is. I think I pretty much know what it is. It is, what zodiac tome? It's in the Lunarium. Alright, when I go there to get the, what are they called? The loungy lizards will pick it up.
We have a small crisis, which I hope you can help with. It involves travel to the world of Zafaria. I was there long ago. Professor Falmea created an exchange program for Ravenwood students to study abroad, but the class has become lost. While it is a lush and vibrant land, Zafaria was once the home of Morganth. Seek out Professor Falmea to learn more.
Well, guys, that's your guys' intro for Zafaria right now. If you guys are hyped about going to Zafaria, hit that like button down below and don't be afraid. Mash it as much as you guys want. It won't break it. And subscribe if you have not yet subscribed to my channel for more wizard and other video game content. And as always, guys, I will see you guys next time for something else. Alrighty. Bye, guys.